CNN political analyst and deputy culture editor of the New York Times, Patrick Healy, host of the Ben Ferguson Show, the man Ben Ferguson himself, and former White House senior director under President Obama, Nayyera Haq. Guys, it's great to have you here. So, first off, Patrick Healy, when you go to this tweet coming from Donald Trump late today, is he wrong? Because if you look at the travel schedule during the campaign, President Obama did campaign hard, and it was really personal for him, for Hillary Clinton, in places like Pennsylvania, Ohio, North Carolina, list them off, and Donald Trump won all the states.
Right. President Obama made it very clear through his political lieutenants to Hillary Clinton that he wanted to campaign hard for her, right, and especially against Donald Trump. He thought that he could bring out a message to rally his base, his coalition, for Hillary Clinton, that he was very well positioned to take it to Donald Trump, to sort of call him out, you know, as inexperienced, as a con man, as someone who wasn't capable of being commander in chief. And I think President Obama still hasn't kind of let go of this. He has a habit, he likes to get under people's skin, not with necessarily frontal attacks, but just sort of like nudge them psychologically. And that is partly what he's doing here, saying, well, I could have won a third term. As we know, that will never be able to be proved. But he knows that anything that makes Donald Trump sound like a loser, possibly, just drives him crazy.
Yeah, so plausible deniability that he's right, actually trying to needle him. But Ben, beyond this point of if Donald Trump is right or wrong with this tweet, which he actually is kind of right, this one interview that President Obama does with David Axelrod, I mean, it clearly got under Trump's skin, but he's gonna have a lot of critiques coming his way over the next 4 years. How is he going to handle it if this bothers him so much?
Well, I think this is an appropriate time for him to respond and to set the record straight on this. When you have the sitting president basically saying, I would have taken you out back and whooped up on you if I was up against you head to head. So I don't have a problem with this. And let's be also honest, if Donald Trump had done an interview today, one of the first questions any reporter would have asked him would have been, hey, President-elect, did you hear what Barack Obama said about you today? And we would have accepted that question coming from a reporter. Instead, we cut out the middleman, and Trump says, yeah, no, you lost, and you would have lost if you were up against me. Hillary Clinton was an extension of Barack Obama. He made that very clear on the campaign trail as well, that if you want to keep my policies going, he even said that in stump speeches, Hillary Clinton is who you need to go out and vote for, and the American people rejected that message. So for him to come out and claim now that he would have won the election, he was out there campaigning, so was Michelle Obama, saying, you want us and what we did to keep going, vote for Hillary, and people said no.
Yeah, Donald Trump can say whatever he wants on Twitter, of course, but again, we would ask him if we would have an interview with him, but he's not doing press conferences yet. Again, Ben Ferguson, must be pointed out. Nayyera, yeah, get in on this.
Well, I mean, listen, any president who's won two terms, whether Democrat or Republican, would probably say the same thing, that, yeah, of course I could win a third term. I mean, this is, if anybody can appreciate a healthy ego, it should be Donald Trump. The challenge is that that ego hasn't stopped being in campaign mode, and that ego has continued onto being a president-elect and governing, and that's the big difference. Having such a thin skin in the campaign, it's carried over on Twitter, is the danger in that, is that any foreign leader now knows, and anybody who's looking to go up against the U.S. knows, that all you have to do is make a random comment and it'll get under his skin. I mean, here's the challenge. Here's the big difference.
Hold on, Ben. Let me finish.
I mean, it is an offhand comment out of a bigger context of what the president was saying even today, which is that this is really what we need, is a time of healing and a time of moving forward and not focusing on divisiveness. I mean, at the end of the day...
But Obama did exactly that.
Okay, go, Ben.
First of all, let's not act like it's thin skin when you have the highest level of trash talking you can possibly have in politics, a sitting president and a president-elect. So it's not thin skin for those two individuals to go after one another.
Patrick makes a fascinating point. Calls him a loser, but kind of questions his winnability, if you will. I mean, we have example upon example of when
when you win an election fair and square.
Two of you are talking to me, and I only have one brain. Hold on, Patrick.
Let's make this one point about Donald Trump to put it in context too, and that's that Donald Trump has said many times that if you hit him, he's going to hit you back 10 times as hard.
Right.
And I will say again, let's put this tweet in context. What Donald Trump tweeted about Obama actually wasn't that vicious. So one could argue that he is, let's say, sort of modulating his tone a little bit. I mean, he always used to say, it's going to hit back 10 times as hard, so they never forget how tough I can be. And with this kind of a tweet, at least, you know, he was basically saying, well, you know, President Obama tried to campaign hard,
again,
but I won.
Not really. Hold on. There are two things. I don't think what Donald Trump really says in the tweet is wrong. I'm just fascinated by the fact that, Ben, no one is questioning the result of the election at all. So who is Trump's audience?
I disagree. Look at how many people have come out there. Almost every Democrat says, well, he didn't win the popular vote.
They're not questioning the outcome anymore.
They're undermining it. Trying to act as if somehow he's not legit. Look at all the stars that came out and did a video begging those in the Electoral College to not vote for Donald Trump,
and
he wasn't really the president.
And here's what Donald could do to really be presidential.
That's unprecedented.
He could ignore it and move on and focus on governing the country.
You're never going to ignore Obama talking trash.
It's a never-ending campaign. I mean, listen, we've lost so many icons from the 80s.
It's a double standard when you don't hold Obama to the same standard.
Let's lose this election and move forward and actually focus on healing the country.
And the part of the problem, and why Democrats keep bringing up the popular vote, as you know, is that some of the people around President-elect Trump keep saying that he has a mandate, keep sort of insisting that American people voted his program into office, his policies, that he won, you know, some kind of a mandate to govern. And what you have here, he clearly won the Electoral College. He clearly is president-elect. He's going to be president of the United States. But the question of, does he have an actual sort of mandate to do the things that he wants to do when he lost
and
the popular vote?
This.
Hold on. I'm cutting this off. We're going to see once and for all if I can actually cut it off with Ben Ferguson. Great.